Hello friends, today in this tutorial I will be telling you that how to capture images from your web camera in Python using a library which is OpenCV. So let me just execute this Python script by executing the command python app.py. If I execute this application, you will see a window appearing and you will see my webcam started here. So now this is a GUI kind of application. Here you can see my web camera. So now in order to take a screenshot, I will press the space key on my keyboard and then it will automatically take the screenshot and it will create this image file inside my directory. So if I press the space key, so you will see that this PNG file has been created. If I again press space like this, it will create these images files automatically. If I check the directory, you will see this is a PNG file. If I open this file, you will see this has taken the screenshot from my web camera and stored it inside my local directory. And now if I want to exit this, I can press the escape key. So now the application is exited right here. So this is a simple Python script. So first of all the source code of this application is given in the video description. You can go to my blog and download the source code. And now in order to make this, you need OpenCV library. So just execute this command pip install opencv-python. I have already installed this library, so I will not install it again. Opencv-python, that's it. This is the only library, and let me delete all the code here. And let me also delete the images that were taken. So now we have just the one file, app.py. So inside this file, first of all, we need to import our OpenCV library. So we will write here import CV2. So this is a shorthand notation for the OpenCV module for Python. After importing the library, we will initialize our web camera, which is CV2 dot. Inside this, there is a video capture method. So we will make sure we use this method, and we need to pass a constant which is 0. So this signifies that we are starting our webcam. And now we can name this our application, give it a title by using named window function. And inside this, we need to call a title of the window, which is Python webcam screenshot app, like this. And now we also need to release our camera, so we will release the camera by the release function. And also we need to destroy all windows at the end of, when we're done with this, we can destroy all windows like this with this function. So now we can just launch our application just to check if it is working or not. So we can write python app.py. so you will see a window will appear, but the window has gone. So we need to make our application. So after you initialize the title, you will initialize a variable which will be image counter, and it will be 0. And then we will run a while loop, while true. So inside this, guys, inside this loop, we will get the image frames of the web camera by executing two variables, ret comma frame, and then we will be reading from the camera cam.read, read function. So you can see that we have initialized our web camera, so we are reading the frames out there by the read function. So after reading the frames, we will check in the if condition. So if not ret, in that case we need to print out a statement. So there is some kind of error, failed to grab frame. And then we need to break it like this. And then if the frames are appearing from the web camera, then we need to show it by the image show method, which is there inside this method. And we need to name our frame. So let's suppose I give it a name such as test and pass the frame, that's it. So basically this line signifies that we are showing the web camera to the user. Now we need to take the screenshot, but first of all we need to bind some hotkeys. So whenever we hit the escape key, we need to close the application. So we will be using this wait key function, and here we will pass the constant 1, and then we need to initialize in the if condition. So if k modulus 256 is equal to 27, in that case we know that the escape key is pressed. So we can exit out the application. So we can just say in the print statement, escape hit, so closing the app. And then in the next line we can break out like this, and we also need to bind one other thing, which is space key. So you can write here else if k modulus 256 is equal to 32, so in that case we know that space key is hit. So then we need to capture the image and store it inside our directory. So we can make an image name variable, and inside this double quotes we can just write opencv underscore frame underscore and a set of curly brackets. So this is a placeholder variable for the images, and then we can just use the format variable, and we can pass the image counter. So basically when you take the first screenshot, the value of image counter will be 0 that we have initialized here. When you take the second image, it will be 1. So opencv frame 0.png, opencv frame 1.png, that's it. So every time we take the screenshot, it will have a random name to the screenshot. Now we need to write this image. So we can use the image write method, which is there. So image write, we can pass the image name that we have, and also we need to pass the frame of which we are taking the screenshot, that's it. And now we can print out screenshot taken like this, and we can increment the value of image counter by 1. So image counter plus is equal to 1. That's it guys. So now the application is complete. Now let me just run the application. So if I run the application, you will see a window will appear. You can see that this is a window. If I hit the space key, you will see this image file will be downloaded and saved in a shadow directory that it is taking the screenshot in the background. And now if I want to exit out the application, I can press the escape key. That's it. So this is a simple screenshot application that we have developed in Python using the OpenCV library, and all the source code is given in the video description. Go to the blog and download the source code. Please like the video, subscribe the channel, and I will be seeing you in the next video.